Today we're going to do Surah Al-Ankabut, Surah number 29. Let's begin with a dua. Nahmadu nusalli ala rasulihi al-kareem. Amma ba'd, fa'uz billahi minash shaitani rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassirli amri. Wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Surah Al-Ankabut, it's a Makki surah, period of revelation. This surah was revealed shortly before the Muslims' migration to Habsha in the middle stage of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam residence at Makkah, when there was extreme persecution of the Muslims. So major issues and divine laws and guidance what discussed in this surah, Allah tests the believers to see who is truthful and who is a liar. And be kind to the parents, but do not obey them in the matter of the shirk, means associating partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also in this we'll discuss those who say, follow us, we will bear your burden on the day of judgment. Those are the liars. You know, some people they ask to follow them and they will bear the burden for themselves. And also if they misguide to the others, for them, they will have the double punishment. And then the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam is mentioned, admonishes his people for 950 years and not to commit shirk. Again, Islamic monotheism. When we see Makki surah, the main topic will be Islamic monotheism and oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not doing shirk. Complete negation of the shirk. And Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is mentioned, admonishes his people not to commit shirk, for which they try to burn him alive, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the fire cool and Allah helped him and saved him. And the nation of Ad and Thamud, Madian and Pharaoh rejected the Rasuls of Allah. As a result, Allah destroyed them all. And parable of those who take protector other than Allah, that will come in ayah number 42 onwards. This is the main core of the surah where Ankabut is mentioned, you know, is that of dwelling of a spider. And in fact, the weakest of the dwelling is the dwelling of a spider. And this surah strengthens the faith of a sincere Muslim and admonishes those who were showing weakness in their faith. The surah also addresses those questions which some young men were facing in those days, and whose parents were urging them to abandon Islam and return to their ancestors' religion. And the Muslims are instructed in this. If you feel that persecution has become unbearable for you, you should give up your home instead of giving up your faith. You know, land is so vast, earth is so vast, leave that place and move on to the migration. But you can't leave the faith. The disbelievers are urged to understand Islam, the realities of Tawheed, oneness of God, and hereafter are presented with rational arguments. Shirk is refuted and their attention is drawn towards the signs in the universe. They are told that all these signs confirm to the teaching of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this was the brief explanation of the surah, what we're going to discuss in this. So as I mentioned, it's a Makki surah. Let's begin. Surah Al-Ankabut, it's a Makki surah. It's begin with Alif Lam Mim. Whenever surah starts with Huruf-e-Muqaddar, mostly talks about book. But here, it's different. Alif Lam Mim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. أحسب, did he thought or assumed or supposed, الناس, the mankind, it's talking about everyone, the people, and that يتركوا, they will be left. يتركوا is from تارا كاف ترك, to abandoning something or leaving something, and that يقولوا, قَالَ يَقُولُ, to say, they say, آمَنَّا, we have believed, وَهُمْ, and they, لَا, not يُفْتَنُونَ, they put in fitna, tried or tested. Allah is asking that they will be left alone on saying we believe and that they will not be tested. Definitely, you're going to be tested. Fitna is from fata, noon, test. Al-imtihan with the severe. Shadidul taqlif and difficulty. Example, illness, disease, suffering, anything. It can be suffering in the, you know, badan and the wealth, both. And literally meanings, fitan, futun is burn gold in fire to purify. So here, for sure, they will be tested. You know how the gold will be burned and it will be purified. The same way, they are going through severe test. So let's see the detail of it. Wherever it's necessary, I'm going to explain those meaning. Like, you know, hasiba, hasinba, hasiba. To assume about something, to think about something. You know, such a thought about person has something. Also hope, okay? That's how hasiba. Taraka is from tarakaf, to leave or abandon. So here, alif lam mim huruf muqattat, only Allah knows the meaning of that. The next ayah, do people think that they will be left alone because they say we believe and will not be tested? And ayah number 3, we see, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلْيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ وَلَقَدْ certainly. فَتَنَّ, again the same word has been used. How the word يُفْتَنُون was there, the formation has been changed. It is فَتَنَّ. And we tested. Why it is we tested? Because noon and the alif with the fatha on it, and we test it. It's because of the shadda, it will be definitely we're going to test it and trial. Allazina, those who mean from qablihim, qaf the alam, before them. Falyalamanna, it's from ayn lam mim, so surely he will definitely know. If you notice that, if you dissect this word, fa is so. La is for surely. It's not la, it's la. La surely ya lamanna, he will definitely know. Why definitely? Because noon has shadda. If you notice that noon has shadda on it, so surely definitely he will know. Allah, allazina, those who sadaqu, swad dal qaf, sadq, sidq, truth. Wala ya lamanna, surely he will definitely know. Al kazibin, kazib is from kab zal ba, kazib, liars. So Allah has to see for the purpose of reward and punishment who are truthful and who are the liars. So Allah is passing through the test to know the reality of the people, whether they are, you know, face the test and they fail or pass. And ayah number 4, am hasiba, am or hasiba, he thought, suppose, Allazina, those who, ya maluna, they do, as-sayyad, the evil. And that, yusbiquna, they will outstrip or outrace us. It's from sabaqa, seen, baqaf, sabaqa. And here, sa'a, how bad or evil is. Ma, whatever, yahkumun, is from ha, kaf, mean, they judge or say. Sabaqa, to get ahead someone. To the and here seen baqaf, you know, sabiquna abbalun, the same sabaqa. And sayya is from seen ya hamza su, everything that makes a person look bad, that is the sayya. And here we see yahkumun is from hukum ha kaf mim, and here it is for they judge or decide. Let's see the detail of this ayahs from 1 to 4. So the believers are tested so that it may know who is sincere and who is lying. So in the beginning of this Suratul Baqarah, we discuss the letters and appear at the beginning of some surahs. I am talking about Hurufi Muqattat. So we are not going to go into that meaning again, because only Allah knows the meaning of that. And here when we talk about ayah number 2, ahasiba nasu an yatruku, do people think that they will be left alone because they say we believe and will not be tested? This is a rebuke. And this is a rebuke in the form of a question, meaning that Allah will inevitably test his believing servants according to their level of faith. And it's recorded in authentic hadith, the people most severely tested are the prophets, then the righteous, then the next best and the next best. A man will be tested in accordance with the degree of his religious commitment. The stronger his righteous religion commitment, the strong is the test. Do you understand this hadith? Like the test will be severe if your iman is more strong. And who are tested? The first, the best of the best. And who are the best of the best? Prophets. And the next best and the next. So and so forth, the list goes on. So don't underestimate things and don't be judgmental. If somebody is going through a severe test or trial, don't start it saying the negative comments, because this hadith clearly says who are being tested, and also the Quran ayahs, and we'll see more ayahs references. The ayah like this is mentioned in Suratul Ali Imran, ayah number 142. Am hasibtum an yadkhulun jannah falamma ya'lamu Allahu allazeena jahadu minkum wa ya'lamu as-sabirin. Do you think that you will enter Jannah without Allah knowing those of you who fought in his cause and knowing those who are patient? So here two things are mentioned. You know, you can't enter Jannah until unless you fought in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second thing, those who have the sabr, patient. And there is a similar ayah in Surah At-Tawbah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, or think that you will enter Jannah without such trials, as come to those who passed away before you. They were afflicted with severe poverty and ailments and were so shaken that even the messengers who believed along with him said, when will come the help of Allah? Yes, certainly the help of Allah is near. And this is mentioned in Suratul Baqara, ayah number 214. Before that was this, that was the thing mentioned in Suratul Tawbah, and this is mentioned in Suratul Baqara. So in this ayah, Allah said, "Am hasibtum?" Again, the ayah start with, or do they think? "An tadkhulul jannah," they will enter Jannah. "Walamma yatikum masalul lazina khalaw min qablikum," and before them, they were also afflicted and tested. Masathum basai wa dorai, and basa and dorra is, you know, severe trials which are afflicted because of poverty, and also dorra is the ailment. It can be physical ailment, tangible and intangible. It can be physically you are going through disease, and intangibly you are going through spiritual problem which we call mental stress. And we're so shaken up. It says, وَدَرَّعِ وَزَلْزِلُ حَتَّى يَقُولُ الرَّسُولَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. And they believe. But when the persecution was so severe, what they say? مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ? When is the help of Allah will come? أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. And the help of Allah is very near. So Allah says here, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ. So in ayah number 3, and we indeed test those who were before them, so that Allah will know those who are true and will know those who are liars. Meaning he will make know which are sincere in their claim to be the believers from those who are lying. Allah, may he be glorified and exalted, knows what has happened in the past and what is yet to come. He knows how that which will not happen would have happened it. You know, Allah knows everything, what's going on, what's going to happen, and Allah will test the people. And the view of Ibn Abbas and other concerning this ayah, illa ni'alam, only that we know, this is in surah number 2 and ayah number 143, that is Suratul Baqara, meaning only to see, because seeing has to do with what is there, but knowledge is broader than seeing, since it includes what is not present as well as what is. The evil doers cannot escape from Allah. Allah said, "Am hasiba allazina ya'maluna sayyiat ay yasbiquna sa'a ma yahkumun." And in this ayah number 4, or think those who do evil deeds that they can outstrip us. Evil is that they judge. Means those who are not believers should not think that they will escape such trials and tests, for ahead of them lies a greater and more severe punishment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, or think those who do evil deeds, they can be outstrippers, meaning they can't escape from us. From whom? From Allah's test, nobody can escape. So let's move to ayah number 5. Ayah number 5 is, Man kana yarju liqa'a Allahi fa inna ajala Allahi la'atin wa huwa sami'ul alim. So two attributes of Allah is mentioned here, sami' and alim. Man, whoever, kana, he was, yarju, he expects or hopes. It's from rajim waw, raja, yarju, to look or hope for something. Fear and hope. Yarju means yatmu, desires, wants. Yakhfu, fear and desires, meeting of Allah in hereafter. So here, yarju, liqa, lam, qaf, ya. And this word came several times from Surah Al-Baqarah for meeting. Allahi Allah, fa inna, then indeed. Ajala, appointed time. That is from Hamza Jimla. Allahi Allah, la'atin, surely one comes. Wa and huwa, he is sami'ul alim. Allah is always all here, and alim, always all knower. Sami is from seen, meem, ayn. Alim is from ayn, lam, meem. And huwa here, zameen, pronoun is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ayah number 6, wa man, and whoever, jahada, he strove, fa innama, then indeed not, but yujahidu is from jim hadal. Again, the same word formation has been changed. He strives. Li is for nafsihi, his own self. If you dissect this word, the main word is noon fasi, nafs. Lam with kasra is for. Nafsi is own. He himself. Inna, indeed, Allahu Allah. La ghaniyun, la here is for surely. Ghani, free of all wants. Ghain noon ya. An from al alameen, the world. Alameen is from alam, ayn lam mim. And this word, right from Surah Fatiha, n number of times has been repeated, this word. So here we see ayah number 5 and 6. And also let's see the ayah number 5, 6 and 7. So that togetherly we'll do the tafsir of it. Wallazina, and those who. Amanu, they believed. Wa amilu, and they did. Amanu and amilu. Amanu, hamza, mim, noon. Amilu, ayn, mim, lam. It's from amal. You know, doing something. It's like an action. As-salihat, swad lam ha-salih, righteous. La nukaffiranna, la surely nukaffiranna, we shall definitely expiate. Kafara, kafar, anhum, from then, kafara, expiation. Takfir, since is cover. And here, anhum, from them, sayyatihim, their evil sins. Wa and lanajziyannahum, surely we will definitely recompense them. So if you notice that I explained you, la is for surely, and noon with shadda is for definitely, and noon with the fatha is for we. Surely we will definitely recompense them or reward them. Ahsana, best. It's from hasinun, allazi, of which kanu, they were, yamalun, they do. It's from ayn, mim, lam. So here, let's see from ayah number 5 to 7. Whoever hopes in the meeting with Allah, then Allah's term is surely coming. And he is all hearer, all knower. And whoever strives, he strives only for himself. Verily, Allah stands not in need of any of the creatures. Those who believe and do righteous good deeds, surely we shall expiate from their evil deeds, and we shall indeed reward them according to the best of that which they used to do, because they are doing the amal. So from ayah number 5, Allah will fulfill the hopes of the righteous. Allah says, Man kana yarju liqa'illah, whoever hopes in the meeting with Allah, means in the hereafter, and does righteous deeds and hopes for a great reward. What is that great reward with Allah? Jannah. Then Allah will fulfill his hopes and rewards him for his deeds in full. This was undoubtedly come to pass, for he is the one who hears all supplication, he knows. Means Allah's sifat has been mentioned, all hearer and all knowing, and understand the needs of all created beings. Allah says, Man kana yarju liqa'illahi, whoever hopes in the meeting of Allah, then Allah's term is surely coming. And he is all hearer and knower. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ النَّفْسِ, and whoever strives, he strives only for himself. And this is like the ayah, مَنْ أَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِهِ. This is mentioned in surah number 41, ayah number 46. Whoever does righteous good deed, it is for himself. فَلِنَفْسِهِ. Whoever does a righteous deed, the benefit of that deed will come back to him. For Allah has no need, because Allah is Ghani, no need of the deeds of his servants. And if all of them were to be as righteous as the most righteous man among them, that would not add to his Allah's dominion in the slightest, not it will diminish. That's how Allah is. Allah is Ghani. Allah don't need us at all. But we are faqir. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ لِنَفْسِهِ, clearly mentioned, we are striving hard for our own self. لِنَفْسِهِ, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ, and Allah is Ghani, free of all the needs and free of all the alameen, means this world and the hereafter. Then Allah tells us that even though he has no need of these creatures, he is kind, generous. He will still give to those who believe and do righteous deeds the best of the rewards, which is that he will expiate for them their bad deeds and will reward them according to the best deeds they did. He will accept the fewest good deeds, and in return for one good deed will give anything between 10 rewards and 700. How we know 10 to 700? Yes, in Surah Al-Baqarah, it's mentioned 10 to 7. But for every bad deed, he will give only one. That's how Allah is. Allah is so Ghafoor Rahim. If you are doing bad, only one is written. But if you are doing good, it can be up to 700. And he may overlook and forgive. This is ayah, like, you know, it's mentioned in Surah number 4, ayah number 40. Surely Allah wrongs not even the weight of a speck of a dust. But if there is any good, he doubles it and gives for him a great reward. Inna Allaha la yazlimu siqala zarra. You know, only a speck, then also Allah will give. Wa in taku hasanatum yudaifuha. Yudaifu, if you see, double or more than that. And yuti min ladunna ajran azima, and here ajran azima is greater reward, that is Jannah. And he says, those who believe and do righteous deeds. So in this ayah number 7, it's mentioned, wallazina amanu wa amilu salihat lanukaffiranna anhum sayyiatihim wa lanajziyannahum أحسن الذين كانوا يعملون. So those who believe and do righteous good deeds, surely we shall expiate from them their evil deeds, and we shall indeed reward them according to the best of that which they used to do. So here ayah number 8 and 9. Ayah number 8 is, and we have enjoined on man to be dutiful to his parents, And if they strive to make you associate with me, which you have no knowledge of, then obey them not. And to me is your return, and I shall tell you what you used to do. And for those who believe and do righteous deeds, surely we shall admit them among the righteous. Let's see ayah number 8 and 9, the Quranic ayah. Wawassayna, wa and connecting ayah. One ayah is connected with the another with waw, but sometimes waw with fatha is for qasmiya, but here for the connecting. Wassayna waw swadiya wasiya. The same thing we use for the wasiya. So here word has been used, we enjoined, entrusted, wasiya. Wasiya is important instruction. It's given at the time of death. Before something goes wrong, you instructed. So this is the word used for the al-insan, means human being. All the insan, all the mankind. Biwaladihi, with the two parents. Be with the two parents. Husanan. And husanan is good. It's not just doing ihsan, it's husanan. Every kind of goodness. It's nakira, all kind of goodness. Husna is beautiful, good behavior. Here, master used for the mubalagha. So here, hasin noon, hasan, husan. It means in this reference, I'm going to explain that word in detail. Husna means beautiful, good behavior. In what sense? Means dutiful to them. To whom? To the parents. And he should be husn, source of pleasure. You know, children, they are source of pleasure. In Surah Al-Furqan, what is Qurratul Ayun? They are coolness of the eyes and the coolness of the heart. If you see the Qurra, Qarar and Qurra, the two coolness, spiritual and the mental, both way. Not only the coolness of eyes over there and the coolness of the heart. So here, something, source of pleasure. So dutiful to them, and he should be husn in source of pleasure. You have to remember this word. Va in and if. But here in is not. It's not here. Why? Because there is no illa, so it is if. In is if here. Jahadaka. They too strove. Jahadaka is from jim hadal jahad. And here striving, they too. Why they too? Jim with alif is there. This is used for dual, which is called in Arabic tasniya. And jahadaka, they too strove against you. It means they both pressurize you, force you. Litushrika, so that you do shirk. Li is for and ka is you. So that you do shirk, associate partners, be with me. With me means with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is mentioned regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma wat laisa, it is not laka for you, bihi, with it, ilmun, any knowledge. Again, nakira. Fala, then do not, tut'i huma, you obey them too. Ta, waw, and ta. And ilayya, to me, only to me. To whom? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Marjiukum, it's from ruju, you return. Fa unabbiukum, so that I shall inform you all. Bima, with whatever kuntum, you all will. Damalun, you all do. Wallazina, and those who they believe, amilu, they did a salihat, righteous deeds. Lanadukhilannahum, surely we shall definitely admit, make them to enter. Fi in among As-Salihin, those who are righteous ones. So let's see the detail of these two ayahs. As I explain you some of the words, the command to be good and dutiful to parents, both the parents, mother and father. But because of separation or because of being biased to one parent, doesn't matter. But what is the main important thing, if they force you for the shirk, you are not going to listen to them. Allah command his servants to be dutiful to parents after urging them to adhere, to believe in his tawheed. Because a person, parents are the cause of existence, isn't it? We came in this world, that they became the, you know, the way to come in this world. But Allah is clearly mentioning, because human beings, they can do mistake. Like sometimes they exaggerate, they exceed the position of the parents. Knows Billah more than Allah and Rasul, because in ignorance they do it. I'm not being judgmental to anyone, but because of ignorance, if something happened like this, don't start it commenting on them. Try to explain to them if something goes wrong, because most of them, they have lack of knowledge. They don't know exactly what they are doing. Because of the culture, especially in Asian countries, they are more affected with the non-Muslims, because they literally touch the feet of the parents and they pray as if they are God. And literally they say parents are like God, Astaghfirullah. And they bend down and they touch their feet, and Muslims, they get affected and they behave that way. But our religion completely condemns that. It's not so. We can't do that. So that is the thing mentioned here. So he must treat them with the utmost kindness and the respect his father for spending on him, and his mother because of her compassion for him. Allah says, this is in surah number 17 and ayah number 23 and 24. Everybody knows about this surah al-Isra. وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ بِالْوَالِدَيْنَ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْحَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا وَاخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنْ رَحْمَتِي وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. And your Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him, that you will be dutiful to your parents, both parents. If one of them or both of them attain old age, إِنَّ الْكِبَرَى أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. Attain old age in your life, say not to them a word of disrespect. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ. Don't say of. Uff is the kalima kariha, which you use for, you know, if you use a Q-tip for wiping your ear, that kariha on the Q-tip, that is the kalima kariha. Or the, you know, dirt in the nail, that is a kalima kariha. That's how bad it is saying uff. How many words are there uff if you say? But Allah don't like it. Allah said that is disrespect. Nor shout at them. Tanhar is like, you know, nahar is such kind of shout that makes them, you know, they feel that awe and terror in their heart. But address them in the terms of honor. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. And lower unto them the wing of submission. وَخْفِدْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحًا زُلِّي. Here, lowering the wing doesn't mean that you touch their feet or bend down in such a manner that you make them God. No, it's not so. It means that you respect them in that manner. And also mean rahmati wa qur rabbir hamhuma kama rabbayani saqira. This is a beautiful dua. You should recite this dua who are alive and who are dead, for both of them. Because beautifully mentioned, my Lord bestow on them mercy as they did bring me up when I was young. Why it's mentioned like bestow on them mercy when I was young? So remember when we were young, when we were child, how they used to, you know, whatever the tantrums we throw, they take it. They never said, if we shout, if we yell and we dirty the diaper, they clean it, they did everything. But now they become a child for us. You understand, now they are feeble, weak, and they are in the old age. Now you have to do good. So beautiful wordings. Rabbir hamuma kama rabbayani sagira. I was young, like, you know, how you brought me up, the same way now we have to be good to them. That's the thing mentioned. Although Allah ordered us to show kindness, mercy and respect towards them in return for the previous kindness, He says, وَإِن جَاهَدَكَ, but if they strive to make associate with me, لِتُشْرِكَ, Allah says, if they are asking you to do shirk, which you have no knowledge, do not obey them. No, you're not going to obey them. Meaning if they are idolaters and they try to make you follow them in their religion, then beware of them and do not obey them in that. For you will be brought back to me on the day of resurrection, and Allah will reward you for your kindness toward them and your patience in adhering to your religion. It is Allah who will gather you with a group of righteous, not with the group of your parents, even though you were closest of people to them in the world. For a person will be gathered on the day of resurrection with those whom he loves, meaning religious love. Means, you know, you get biased with your parents and whatever the bad aqeedah they have, and you are following it and you are not even saying that. I'm not saying you should reprimand them. No, never ever. But at least try to convey the message. Tell them in a nice manner. Nobody is saying to scold them, but you have to convey the message. And for yourself, you have to show with your behavior that you are not promoting those. But some of them, instead of telling them nicely, they get carried away. And just to make them happy, they do those things. Not only doing, they spend their halal money in the haram. In the all the things which are misconception. You don't get anything, believe me, whether dead or alive. Whatever the things you are doing culturally, which are not according to Quran and Sunnah, you are not getting anything. Instead, you will get the punishment for it. So beware of that. And here, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and for those who believe and do righteous good deeds, surely we shall make them enter with the righteous. Is here the tafsir of this ayah, Tirmidhi recorded that Saad said, four ayahs were revealed concerning me. Oh Saad, he told his story. He said, Umme Saad said, did Allah not command you to honor your parents? By Allah, I will not eat or drink anything until I die, or you renounce Islam. When they wanted to feed her, they would force her mouth open. Then this ayah was revealed. And we have enjoined on man to be dutiful to his parents, but if they strive to make you associate with me, of which you have no knowledge, then obey them not. This is regarding the Sahaba Saad. This hadith was also recorded by Imam Ahmad and Muslim. So this was the authentic narration. This is Sahih in regarding to the Sahabi Saad, because she wants to revert. But even though that was the thing, that was the test going on, still he didn't do that. When it comes to the religion matters, you shouldn't respect in that manner. And we are not saying to be, disrespectful to your parents. Kindly tell them. There are few more places in Quran where Allah says, when they are asking you to do shirk, do not obey them. But in the matter of the worldly things, you will be kind and good to them. Even Sahaba and Ummahat al-Mumineen, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam always appreciate that they should respect their parents. He never said to reprimand or to say or yell at them. Never. Our religion never taught that way. Sunnah, our beloved Prophet Sunnah was never that way. But the only thing, we are not going to cooperate on the basis of Tawheed. Never ever, no matter what. Because you will be among the group which you have the same religion. Doesn't matter what ukhwa you have, what blood relation you have. But you will be among the people who are on the same religion. If you are misguided, then you are with the misguided people. جزاك الله خيرا كثيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك